there's just not much optimism. Everybody's just kind of holding their breath, and hopefully we'll see what the season brings.
If you talk to Jim Mullen, executive director of the Maryland Oystermen's Association, the prognosis for this year's oyster season is not good. Mainly because of all the rain we've had over the past couple of months.
In the month of July, we had almost 40 inches of rain, so all that fresh water didn't help matters much.
The problem mainly started up the bay at the Conowingo Dam, which had to open a majority of its gates to let a tremendous amount of water and debris through. The result, salinity levels went down dramatically in normally salty portions of the bay, killing adult oysters and stunting the growth of babies.
Oysters haven't had an opportunity to kind of grow. You know, they need that salinity in order to grow. And with the lack of salinity in all the fresh water, just not an opportunity to grow to market size.
In fact, DNR recently did a test in the bay near Rock Hall in Kent County and found an oyster mortality rate of 26%. Usually the mortality rate is 5% or less. So now the question is, what can be done? Well, the Oyster and Watermen, in partnership with the Chesapeake Bay Foundation, are trying to plant more oysters, but it could take years to reap those rewards. So in the meantime, those in the seafood industry on the Eastern Shore will have to hope that things can turn around.
It's just a wait-and-see approach, unfortunately. It's the unknown of the unknown.
So these watermen will have until the end of March, when oyster season ends, to see how things go. If you'd like to keep up on the progress, we've got some links on our website, WBALTV.com, and our mobile app. On Kent Island, I'm Lowell Melser, WBAL-TV 11 News.